Hello everyone, I welcome you all to Geeky Script. First of all, a very happy new year to all of you. Today I'm going to show you how to install Android Studio on the Windows operating system. And after that, I'm also going to show you how to use this Android Studio for creating Android apps and how to run that too on your Android phone. So first you need to go to favorite browser and to type over here Android Studio download. Hit enter. So just simply go to there firstly. This link I'm going to provide right in our video description. Once when you're here, you will get this download Android Studio button. So the latest version is Android Studio Auto 2 feature drop. So that is what we are going to download. If you are getting some another version over here, the process that I'm going to show you on this video will be pretty much same. Just simply click on this download button. These are all license agreement. You must read it and accept it and click on download Android Studio. And it's going to immediately start downloading your Android Studio. Just wait for a few minutes over here and you can see that our Android Studio is ready to download. And just simply click on this installer. You can minimize your browser. And here is our Android Studio setup. And when it asks you for administrative privileges, click on yes. And welcome to Android Studio setup. Click on next. Here it will tell you whether you'd like to also install the Android virtual device. So I'll recommend you to uncheck this because we are going to use our Android phone itself to run any Android app that we are going to build. So that's why I recommend you to uncheck this and click on next. And here also you need to keep it default and click on next. Again, keep it default and hit install. And it could immediately start installing Android Studio. And there you go. Our installation is rightly completed. Just simply click on next. Click on finish. That's going to start our Android Studio. Here is our Android Studio OTA 2 feature drop. So it's going to download some of the add-ons. Just keep on waiting. And welcome to Android Studio. Click on next. Now it will again ask you what type of installation you want. I'll always recommend you to proceed with custom and click on next. Here, as I had told you, we are going to use our Android phone itself, so we don't need any virtual device. That's going to unnecessarily going to take a lot of space for our hard drive, so we don't want that. We'll only going to install the necessary items and click on next. Click on next again, accept the license agreement and click on next. And it's going to immediately start downloading and going to install some of the packages. So you need to have active internet connection during the installation. And there you go. You can see everything is done now. So Android SDK is updated. Just simply click on finish. Welcome to Android Studio. You can maximize this now. Just simply click on this plus icon to create a new project. Here, let's proceed with empty activity and click on next. Here you need to provide project name. So let's give the project name as welcome to Android. And minimum SDK is currently selected as API 24. If you want to change to something little latest version, so like currently API 24 going to support about 99.2% of the devices, and you can proceed with API 28 maybe, that is Android 9 Pie. So about 95.3% of the devices is going to support, which is a decent one. So I'm going to proceed with that, and it will be Kotlin, which is also a recommended language in these days. So we are going to proceed with Kotlin and going to click on finish. That's going to start creating our project. So it's going to take some time to load all the components and set this project for use. So have some patience. It's going to take some time, maybe 5 minutes, you know, to get fully loaded. Just wait for some time over here. So you can see it is importing some of the packages. So wait for some time to get all the background tasks get done. So you can see it is really taking good amount of time. So our syncing is done now. Now it is setting up and running some of the configurations. So now wait for a few more minutes. And there you go. You can see finally it is done. So you can expand this app and you will get a Kotlin plus Java folder. So you can expand that as well, and you can expand this package and you will get this main activity.kt. So that exact file is opened over here. And now I'm going to show you how to run this project right on your Android phone. So for that, first you need to click on this node devices, and that will show you these paired devices using Wi-Fi. So you're going to use our Wi-Fi to connect with our phone and laptop over the same network. So click on these paired devices over Wi-Fi, and here is our QR code. Now let's jump onto our Android phone and go to settings and click on my phone, then scroll down a little you will get version info, go there, and you will get build number over here. So keep on clicking this build number. So see, 3 steps away from being a developer, 2 steps away, 1 step away from being a developer, and finally you are a developer. So you need to confirm by putting your pattern, and now you are a developer. Next, you need to go back and scroll down. You will get system, open that, and scroll down again, and you will get developer options over here. So go inside. See, now we have developer options enabled. Next step that you need to do is to enable this wireless debugging. So enable that. Always allow on this network, click on allow, and it is ready, done now. Next thing that you need to check is your phone and your laptop must be connected over same network. Once you have that, next you need to press and hold this wireless debugging that going to show you this screen. Here you need to proceed with pair devices with QR code and use this scanner to scan this QR code, so it's going to immediately start pairing your device. See, it's rightly started to connect to that device. And there you go. It is connected. Success. Just simply click on close. And here is our device is also rightly recognized. Now, all you need to do is to click on this run button. It's going to immediately start building our application and going to install it on our Android phone. So our building is completed. It started installing our application on our phone. And here is our application. Hello Android, launched on our phone. So if you update something on your code, so like for this name variable, if you update instead of Hello Android, if you make Hello Geeky Script subscriber and click on this rerun button, it's going to install our app again on our phone and going to show you Hello Geeky Script subscriber. So whatever you have written, so that's going to show you on your phone. And you are going to see that application installed on your phone just like any other app. Similarly, I have built one more application called this quiz app. This is just a basic demonstration of application that you can create on Android Studio. This is just a basic quiz app. So what is the capital of France? You give Paris. Then which planet is known as a red planet? Again, it is Mars. Who wrote Romeo and Juliet? So it is William Shakespeare. So you can see correct. Then what is the boiling point of water? Again, it's 100, but I'm going to give another answer so that it shows incorrect. So you can see it is wrong, and my score, it shows 3 out of 4. So this type of applications or even much more better application you can obviously create using Android Studio, and you can run that on your Android phone. So soon I'm going to post more videos on Android Studio on this channel. So please do subscribe this channel. You can also join our community and also mention on our comment sections whether you are loving these videos. I really love reading all of your comments. Please do comment, that's going to really motivate me to make more this similar kind of videos. And if you're interested on Python, I highly recommend you to follow this cool Python project playlist. I'm sure you're going to love all these different projects that I have created. Or if you're interested on WordPress, so for that also I have this playlist. So do follow my other videos, I'm sure you're going to love them. So that's basically all about this video. Thank you very much for watching this video. God bless you all.